Hi, I'm Gus Lorenz, extension entomologist for the University of Arkansas, and what you see behind me is a soybean field. You know, it's mid-September. It's that time of year. We have a late crop this year in soybeans, and what goes along with the late crop, obviously, are insects. And we have a lot of pressure in this field today. This is actually, we're right outside Marianna at the Lawn Man Cotton Branch Experiment Station in some of my plots. But I want to show you some of the damage and some of the things that we're seeing out here right now. So what we got going on in this field, there's several things. You can see the immature brown stink bug nymph, and it's distinctive from the green stink bug that you see beside it here. And then here's the brown stink bug adult between my thumb and my forefinger, just to show you the different stages that we have out here right now. And here is what's caused this defoliation that we've been looking at. That's called the bean leaf beetle, and it's characterized usually by, it may or may not have those spots on the back, but they all have the little triangle behind the neck. Here's a red one with no spots on it, but it still, again, it has the black triangle right behind the neck. So they come in several different colors. We not only have bean leaf beetles and stink bugs, but we also have soybean looper coming in the field. The soybean looper is characterized by the two pairs of prolegs. Loopers are the only species that have two pairs of prolegs. Bean leaf beetles a lot of times will cause extensive defoliation in the upper part of the plant, but what you need to look at is not just the top of the plant, but look down through the canopy and look at the level of defoliation across here. When I look at this leaf in particular right here, you know, our threshold is 25 to 30% defoliation. And what I see here is we've exceeded that threshold, but on this leaf right here, you know, we're only at about 10 to 10%. So, you know, when you're looking at defoliation and trying to make a decision on whether or not you've reached that threshold of 25% defoliation, you need to look at the entire plant and not just that part up in the top. The thing about loopers is, they're just the opposite of bean leaf beetles. They like to start down in the lower part of the canopy on the older, tougher leaves, and then they work their way up into the new growth. And so you got loopers coming in from the bottom and bean leaf beetles coming in from the top. The thing is, if we come in and treat these stink bugs with a pyrethroid to get them under control, what it actually does is destroys the beneficial complex, kills all the parasites and predators, and kind of opens the door then for the loopers to blow up. So what you've seen out here today is a combination of pests, and in that situation, at this time of year, it's going to take more than one insecticide to clean up this mess out here. And in the case of the stink bugs and the bean leaf beetles, you know, probably a product of choice might be for those two would be bifenthrin, which is a product, a trade name would be like Brigade, Fanfare, Discipline, Sniper. There's several different brands at a rate, you know, somewhere around a gallon to 25 to 30 or something like that, just to get those under control. But as I mentioned earlier, if you spray a pyrethroid out here, the chances of you blowing that looper complex up, the loopers that are out here, is pretty great. So, because you're also wiping out your beneficial complex. So in that case, you have a few options on products for loopers that you would tank mix with that bifenthrin. Prevathon, Besiege, Belt. Another that may be a little cheaper alternative would be Intrepid. So those are the products that have been proven to be very effective for loopers. So you got to tank mix one of those, and for that situation, it's a pretty expensive treatment when we get into trying to control more than one pest species in that product. There's just not one product that gives good control.